Hi guys! My name is Petya and this is my daughter Svetlozara, or Zara in short. We are from Bulgaria and she is a child with achromatopsia. Actually, we currently know only of her as a person with a diagnosis in our country. And and I want to share some information that was useful for us. And I hope that it will be also useful for you. We found about the exact diagnosis maybe 8 months ago after we had our gene testing results done. The gene she has misaligned is PDE6C and it is a very rare one. There are two more popular genes that are causing achromatopsia, but that's our case. The first symptoms I noticed when she was just a baby at the age maybe of 8 or 10 months. And the first signal was the nystagmus. She has a very rapid one that it is hard to notice from far, but if you look at her eyes closely, you will see that her pupils are moving really fast. With time, we also noticed the light sensitivity, and with years it got worse. I don't know if in future it will get even worse, but maybe at the age of 2 it was better, at the age of 5 it was worse, then it was a 2 and so on. And also we noticed about her low vision. Currently her vision with normal glasses is 20/200. And also I'm going to talk a little more about how we cope with that at school and in other normal activities. So, I don't know where to begin with. Okay, let's begin with the low vision. So, regarding the low vision, we took her to our first ophthalmologist appointment when she was 1 year old. We wanted to discuss the nystagmus. At that age, it was impossible to track anything more. So we were reassured that the reason for the nystagmus was not anything neurological. At the age of 2, we visited the biggest eye center for kids in our country, and since then she's been followed there. So we started with some simple glasses. Then we had to add also sunglasses because, as I said, her light sensitivity got worse. We knew she may have some low vision, but it was maybe at the age of 5 or 6 when we were able to say properly that she cannot see things in far distance. And her vision since then has kept pretty the same. We change the glasses pretty often. Here I say the normal glasses because we are using some other devices. So currently she's using just a second, these simple ones. She's using these simple ones mainly when she's out playing. When she's swimming or something like that, but of course she never uses them that clear because outside she cannot go out without anything preventing her from the sunlight. So she has this red filter for a few months now. We have it as a clip-on because we often change the prescriptions of the glasses, and changing all the time the red filter is not very nice. So we have this clip-on and the prescription is on this one. Sometimes when she's swimming, because we lost one of these filters in the pool and it got in the filter system, so when she's swimming, having a good time by the sea or in any pool or something, we use this simple clip-on. It is a simple sunglass filter. It is not doing the job the red one does, but it is useful in case your filter got down in the pool and then get lost. So this is regarding the simple glasses she uses at school, because she will be third grade in about a month. She is using these mini telescopic glasses. With these mini telescopic glasses, her vision improves from 2200 to 2050, even 2040. She is able to watch television from a normal distance, I would say a few meters away. She is also able to even play her PlayStation, which was something she very much adores. She is able to see at the school board. And also, these mini telescopic glasses, they have this device you can turn from from looking far to looking near. So she can read, for example, in her school books, and her vision also improves there. So these mini telescopic glasses, they were really a life changer for us. She doesn't need any laptops or any panels that have this enlargement to make her see better. Here I don't know the terminology in English, so you excuse me. I'm sure you know what kind of devices I'm talking about. And very recently we also purchased this new clip-on. It's coming from the United States, and it's helping her a bit with the colors, because you know, with achromatopsia people don't see colors. So far I have noticed that she sees different colors of gray, and depending of the different tint, different contrast and so on, she names this color, for example green or blue or something else. She sees the red as black, and in our language, in Bulgarian, the words for red and black are very similar. So when she was little, I was just thinking that she's mistaken with the names of the colors. And with time I understood that actually she's the red and the black the same. So we purchased this clip-on, and with the tests we made for color blindness, she showed an improvement. So there was maybe a 60% improvement. She loves to draw. It's very weird. She loves to draw, and we bought this clip-on to make her feel easier and more comfort when she's drawing. I'm going to show you some of her paintings at the end of the video. So this is how we cope with the low vision, and actually how we cope with the light sensitivity. For the low vision we use the mini telescopic glasses, for the light sensitivity we use the red clip-on. I don't know if it's in her hand. So we use this clip-on, and we also rarely use the simple sunlight filter when there's a chance for her to lose it, of course, outside, when there is a lot of sunlight, like it's now in Bulgaria, it's summer and so on, she always goes out with head width, so that the sun doesn't go in here. We know about lenses. We know about lenses, and we are going to talk also with our doctor and check if it will be a good option for her, because I know that with lenses, the light is not going in here, and it is very much better with the light. I would also like to add, maybe people of you who have achromatopsia already know it, but at night everything gets much better, and when the light is not in the way, her vision is more accurate. At night I see worse, and she's helping me then. So at least this is something I find good, because you know, with people, with other, for example, Conrad, Ristufi and so on, this is not the case. We didn't have a diagnosis for years. We had the symptoms, we had the nystagmus, the strabismus, the low vision, the light sensitivity and so on, but we didn't have a diagnosis. And I had to search a lot in the internet what possible diagnosis could be there. I was thinking about ocular albinism, and this is where I was able to find the mini telescopic glasses that Professor Ahmed offered us. So I was looking in ocular albinism, I was looking in groups for cone dystrophy, I was looking for at the time even achromatopsia, and I was not sure where my girl fits. There are different advices, there are different developments of the disease in time, and of course you can never know how it will develop with her, but I hope that it will not get worse, and this is what achromatopsia should be like. As far as I know, it should at least not get worse. So it was a year of trying to find the right place where we fit in, and not having other people with similar symptoms and diagnosis in our country is also not very easy for us, because she cannot meet a child who sees the way she does. She doesn't speak English yet, she can say just a few words in English, so it is not a very good sign. About her, she does everything. Her father taught her how to ride a bike. She has her own YouTube video channel. Actually, I'm going to upload this video in her channel because I don't have mine. She does great in school. She has friends. I was scared that she will be feel a lot left out, but actually she's doing everything not just great, she's doing it even better than many of other children her age. So I can say that all my fears, they were totally useless, and having the support that she's able to do anything maybe helped her to believe it and actually do it in real. Sensitivity, I can say that is the worst thing that she feels. She copes with the low vision, she copes with the strabismus and the nystagmus and so on, but the light sensitivity, it is really disturbing. She cannot go out without her sunglasses. It's actually impossible. She squares her eyes. Maybe she feels, I don't know, even some kind of not only discomfort, but she doesn't describe it as pain, but I'm sure that the feeling is not pleasant at all. So when there is a lot of light and she has to go down some stairs outside, it's really hard for her. So that's all in short. That's all I have to say right now on the subject. There are a lot of fears that I feel about how she is going to develop as an adult when she has to go out alone, because currently she is always going out with a parent or another adult. How she is going to cope with crossing the streets. You know that there is a difference between being blind when you use a cane and being normally sighted. She is somewhere in the middle. She doesn't see some things properly, and it's difficult to describe it to other people and for them to understand it, because they know of people being blind as the main group of people with sight disabilities, and explaining low vision is hard. In our country, a lot of things are not developed well for people with low vision or with no vision at all, and this is another thing that is disturbing me. But let's hope that we will be able to find some good teachers that will help us teach her how to cross the street, how to manage everything that other people with low vision do. And after, at the end of the day, I can say that actually everything is great. As I said, I have many fears, but with time they prove to be something that I should have not feared of. And she has a normal childhood, she has everything other children her age have. She develops perfectly and is a child that we are very proud of. Let me show you some of her paintings and we are going to end this video because I'm afraid it got a bit longer than expected. So this is one of the paintings she did. Of course I had to help her with the colors. I saw in one Facebook group that parents are labeling the colors so they can help their children, and I'm about to do it. Also, I'm going to place these notes on the pencil or on the paint tube, saying what color it is, so that it can be easier for her. For example, this is a painting that I have not helped with the colors. So you can see that it has pretty weird colors, but actually they are all combined great. And this should be, I don't know, maybe a sky at the top, grass at the bottom, and a swing. This round thing in the middle of the swing, I'm not sure if it is the sun or anything else, but as I said, she loves to draw. I'm going to show you some other things that she has done only with a pencil, without colors, because then it's easier for her.
It is a panda. It is a cat, Maya.
Okay, so indeed she really loves to draw, and I found it pretty amusing because I never thought that people with such visual disabilities will love to do something like that. This is what we had to say in our first video about achromatopsia. I know I've been a little bit chaotic, but I hope you excuse me. I'm here to answer all kind of questions you may have as parents of children with achromatopsia, because I'm sure that adults with achromatopsia have a lot of more to say than me. I'm just observing her, and I hope that when she is old enough, she will be able to share her experiences. I know that her channel is in Bulgarian, and most probably you won't be able to understand everything she says, but she will be really happy if you subscribe for her channel. Кажи как се казва канала?
Звездинка!
We video everything that we do, for example when we go on a holiday, when we go on different trips in our country or not only in our country. When she draws, when she's shopping for something interesting and so on. And we want to share everything that with the world in order to show them how a child with a visual disability develops and listens. That at the end of the day everything's great. So have a nice day. I hope you had received some useful information, and I'm going to answer on all your comments below in this video. Bye!
Bye!